Yes.
So, we shall start with the
Now, what is the question for social media?
Yes.
In your experience, have you come across organizations defining the social media policies or appointing a basic social media executive?
Okay. In my business, okay, fine. I work with organizations and as working with organizations in my 6-year-old career as a kind of online consultant with different parameters. I worked with 15 different organizations. And in all those organizations, there's always a website policy of what goes into the website, whose details goes into the website. One. Second, it also depends upon what and all are going to be the different social media presence. Which are the social media sites that's going to be there, where the company is going to have, the organization is going to have a presence. One. Who is going to be the main person handling it? A lot of times, even the company's owner, the organization's owner, does not have the right to go and post something on the page. It's done through a person who actually maintains it and knows in and out about that page and how customers interact with that page, interact with the organization on that page. So even if the boss has any info to be posted, that info goes to a specific person who then reframes it in a way of the normal conversation and then it goes on. So yes, organizations, whether it's small-based organization or large-based organization, policies are there in India. And policies are something which is necessary, and there should always be a dedicated person, depending upon which type of social media you're dedicating.
Frankly speaking, as a management consultant, and what we advise organizations, there is some basic lesson for social media policies. One common problem that I come across from the management is misuse.
Facebook or whatever. 8 days I was traveling, I would come back, and then I want to execute orders because it's a commitment. And with so much of appointment, I say, you know, appointment calling and say, so and so, shall I come? I'm driving for 22 kilometers, sitting in front of him, and then waiting for the price of spares, which are so much of food are lying in Middle East, where small spares, and for which I am waiting. These people are literally playing, you know, how many
calls for a very severe attention, isn't it? The customer loss would be a very damage.
I told him for 30 numbers or maybe for just about 100,000, I mean, so-and-so, then Dhiram sir, two people to go to Hyderabad, to go to Cochin. A client in Chennai, I am coming to your place. You are literally not going to
learn. Sorry.
I said, this sorry is not real. That makes a lot of difference between, I am in between two generations or three generations. I've seen,
I think we are also.
Carrying a briefcase, running around to a client and asking for business and keeping the briefcase on the bike tank. And today, a client is coming and the guys are playing. And I committed to separately stating that I'm coming. Because he called me and said, I'm coming because he told me, I saw in the message also. This information and what Mr. Tamil Arasan has spoken, it's a conglomeration of information. It's good. It's fantastic. Very good. And I feel that it's worth that I have come.
Thank you so much, sir. That's something that I'm really proud of. Any other questions, please? Because of paucity of time.
You are talking about this scenario where the company is trying to pay for itself larger cost in social media. What happens in a scenario where we don't have a page, but somebody goes and misuses the brand? How do you control it?
Okay, this is a good question. What are the two biggest social media? The two biggest social media are the mobile phone and something known as Google. They are the two biggest social media where any information can go on. I mean, like, if you're going to post it to something, some info in Facebook, only people who are there in Facebook is going to have an access. If you're going to post something in LinkedIn, only people who are going to be in LinkedIn are going to have an access. But anybody can go to your Googler, to Google search engine, and they can just type it, and they can get any information. And yes, there is a huge possibility of brand theft when it comes to the brand theft, depending upon what is the brands, especially SMEs. SMEs are, you know, like people who are just starting up, consultants, individuals, you know, where people just lift off their name and they try to make it and they talk to them. So what needs to be done? One, the companies who think their brand has a potential that they can go and have an online presence or something may happen on online world, they need to first go and claim their online presence. When I say claim, they can just go create a page in Facebook or anything for that matter, just get their domain name for that matter. Because once a person, suppose say for example you have an organization and I buy a domain name of your organization, in your organization, www.yourorganizationname.com, then I make the choice of how much I will like you to pay me to get the domain. Nobody, no code, no person can come and tell you that I have to pay you. Even if you have registered yourself elsewhere. That's high intelligence.
That's a new trend of business.
It's a new trend. It's like more than a new trend of business is happening for more than 10 years.
Yeah.
I mean, like, you know, websites.
People are quoting more than 4 lakh, more than a million they are quoting.
The lowest price, it is known as website spinning. The technical term is website spinning. The starting price can be somewhere between, depending upon your organization, the starting price is $1,000. Starting price.
So people, they are aware of social media, but they don't aware of cyber laws. If someone is getting attacked, in the websites or in the platform,
okay,
they don't know how to control that or how to come out of that.
Okay.
And there is a less awareness of cyber law in India, I believe.
Yes.
And people have to be get more knowledge about cyber laws.
Yeah, there is cyber law and there is also cyber law cell of, you know, like all legal departments. All legal departments and all government organizations, they have their own cyber setup. And it's up to the people to go on and find out what is it there exactly. It's up to the people, you know, like the organization and the person. Everybody cannot go and, you know, like, feed it into every person's mouth that this is what is happening and this is what is there and come and meet it. It becomes, like, again, you know, how you are going to know your fundamental rights. It becomes the individual's responsibility to go on. So if it is social media, I mean, like, the term social media is itself becoming obsolete. In another 2 years of time, there's going to be nothing more on social media. It's just going to be media, as far as India is concerned. If You go to US, there is no social media now. It's only media. And what is social media? It's something very simple. Whatever you have, magnify it and show it to people. If you have something good, that will get magnified and shown to people. If you have something bad, it will get magnified and shown to people. Want to test it? Just go home, go to Google, type your name, type your organization name. You will see what are the material available. That's it.
Thank you. Thank you so much,
Raja.
And I'm sure, about Tamil, what about the Maharaja's contact? Will you be sharing it?
Yeah, I'm sure.
So in case Tamil or Maharaja's contact need for